that woman?
Margot placed.
The boss brought back.
No idea. I wonder.
Boss!
Salt 2 still hasn't gone into effect. That treaty was drawn up to limit not just the size of the U.S. and Soviet Union's nuclear arsenals, but also their delivery systems. The whole deal. That's when we thought all those years of negotiations had paid off. Somebody decides to invade Afghanistan. The timing couldn't have been worse. The president was in the middle of the Salt 2 talks back then. Maybe while you were busy trying to stop Peace Walker? I heard. President Ford was meeting with the General Secretary in Vladivostok. In his absence, the political brass in America detected what they didn't realize was false nuclear launch data from Peace Walker. They were on the verge of ordering a retaliatory nuclear strike. Coleman's big idea? Humans are incapable of destroying themselves. Turns out he never knew what humans are capable of. If that AI, I mean, the boss, hadn't found a way to stop the fake data transmission, they probably would have gone ahead with the launch. Deterrence was revealed as the pipe dream it was. All thanks to you. And her. The U.S.-Soviet talks looked set to fall through. What happened in Nicaragua no doubt helped trigger a change of heart. But in the end, the times define the politics. When you've grabbed their tail, they turn and bite your hand. I first met you 20 years ago now. The place was Seleniuyarsk in the Soviet Union. We were enemies. I was with the GRU. You were still fighting for America. 1964. Operation Snake Eater. Its objective? The assassination of the legendary soldier known as the Boss. When you returned home successful, they awarded you the title Big Boss. Your CO, Zero, sought to carry on the Boss's will by covertly establishing his own organization. You knew the original members from Operation Snake Eater. From America, there was David O, or as he was to you, Major Zero. Donald Anderson, a.k.a. Sigint. Dr. Clark, who went by paramedic during the operation. And the fourth, you. From China, there was Eva. And me, Ocelot, from the Soviet Union. Six in total. To us, government notions of friend and foe were meaningless. As were East and West, we joined forces by our will alone. Our objective was to fulfill the boss's dying wish, to make the world one. And to do it, Zero used the Philosopher's Legacy, the secret war fund you obtained during Operation Snake Eater. This organization would go on to become Cypher. I, on the other hand, was left with the problem. You only recovered half of the legacy. I had to locate the other half myself. When I found the funds, I passed them on to Zero, just as you wanted. I still trusted him in those days.
We thought what he was doing was the boss's will, until he started that one project.
Les Enfants Terribles, Zero called it.
You parted ways. As did Eva, leaving only Anderson and Clark still with him. I maintained limited contact. Although, truth be told, we were just keeping tabs on one another. The reason was always you. After you returned to the Army and created Foxhound, you left America. For a time, even I'd lost track of you. I'd imagine Zero did, too. You always were the best when it came to hide-and-seek. Zero created Cypher, an information network to tap into every corner of the globe. Woven together, Cypher's arteries make the world just one big organism. And that's not all. It also monitors the thorn in Zero's side. That's you, tracking your coordinates wherever you might go. The further you strayed from your roots, the larger Zero became. It's
as if he was trying to close the gap between you. But before long, he disappeared from public life. Only a few people had direct contact with him. For a time, I was one of them. Then a year after you fell into your coma, he slipped out of sight entirely. Since then, nothing. No photos, no recordings, not even a reliable rumor as to his whereabouts. I tried every method I could think of, but Zero was gone. Freed of his control, his creation, his power continued to grow. Cypher is a great beast, and Zero was its spine. But even without him, it's endured, evolved. But now its body is rotting, riddled with parasites. Parasites like the ones who attacked you 9 years ago in the Caribbean, and then at the hospital. Cypher's Black Ops unit, XOF. They learned where you were, and came to wipe the slate clean.
Ops list updated. Please select a mission. Unit dispatched.
What about the unit that attacked us in the mist? You knew something about them. That wasn't my first run-in with them. It happened right before I was captured by the Soviets. We were on the Zero line that day. The Afghan side. On our way back from training Mujahideen at a mountain camp in Kunar province. There's a lot of that work in Afghanistan. Most PFs shy away from it because it draws too much attention. But for us, that was the whole point. The job itself went great. We just had to make it back to a tribal area in Pakistan. But all of a sudden, visibility got real bad. It was no sandstorm. Our point man gave this strange report. He said he could see skulls in the mist.
Skulls?
The next moment, he went silent. We scrambled into formation, right before his arms and legs came raining down on us. It was always supposed to be a dangerous mission, so I had Diamond Dog's very best with me. We were calling out to each other. One by one, the voices just went dead. Whatever happened to me, I lost consciousness before I knew it. When I came to, I was in a Soviet camp, tied to an interrogation chair.
Could they be some new Spetsnaz unit?
No. The ones that interrogated me were just the average rank and file. Whatever group attacked us, the way they moved was just insane. And that mist, appearing out of nowhere. The Soviets don't have tech like that.
If they did, Ocelot would have heard about it.
I doubt the West does either. Otherwise, the folks at Langley would be sleeping a lot easier.
Why'd they come after you?
Wish I knew. I'm the only one who survived. Though I don't think they planned it that way. If I was their target, they wouldn't have just handed me over to the 40th Army. Whatever the case, we need to watch our step until we know who they really are. And boss, if you ever do run into them again, don't try to take them on. You just get the hell out of there.
When I first started dealing with Zero, with Cypher, it was a somewhat parasitic relationship. Though, a mutually beneficial one. Cypher had no army of their own, so they wanted us. They wanted our strength. They approached me as a potential business partner.
But they had other motives.
Cypher coaxed us into Central America, into that US-Soviet proxy war, to fuel Mother Base's growth. Once we were big enough, they'd force us to join them. That was the plan.
That's why they had Paz, still Zeke.
Right. And if we refused, she would use Zeke to fire a nuke from Mother Base. The world would consider us a liability, and countries would unite to destroy us.
We stopped the launch.
And yet they still took us down, through that fake inspection they orchestrated to cover up their sabotage. That power Cypher wanted. We don't have it anymore. So why are they still after you? Is it just the fear of leaving you alive?
I don't know. Was Zero really... All I know is the man I knew wouldn't want this.
What do you mean?
We have to consider that it might not be Zero we're dealing with.
We know virtually nothing about Cypher anymore. How big they've gotten, what they want, or even who they really are. The new Mother Base started out as a test drilling rig operated by a mineral resources supplier, but their project fell through. The Seychelles government...
That container's filled with raw materials. Looks like they're using those colored bands on the outside to tell the contents apart. Whatever's in them, they'll come in handy somehow for Diamond Dogs.
From the outside, it looked like the project was back on rails.
Kaz, you...
What?
I see what you're doing. Recreating the Mother Base we had 9 years ago. Only this time.
That's right. The Mother Base Cypher thought they destroyed will return from the grave to kill them. We'll prove to the world that we were the victors.
And if we lose again?
They can't fool us the same way twice. Now our enemies are in plain sight. And when our organization gets too big, we split it across companies. Any company that draws attention gets liquidated, and its capital is back-channeled into a new company. Most PFs are small-time operations anyway. And in this business, the minnows go bankrupt all the time. We've never aroused suspicion. Plus, we have Hewick.
Hewick?
Human Exploitation Company. It's a business specializing in intel gathering. Think of it as a civilian intelligence agency.
Kaz, that's...
Remember what they were trying to accomplish at the prison facility in Cuba? That gave me the idea. We dispatch moles into conflict zones around the world, and each sets up an intel network on site. Then they stay in place to give us stable points of contact when other nations intervene in the conflicts. Hewick's strength is that it has a cutout at each level. You get your job from one guy, then you hand it off to another,
No one has direct access. It's a perfect black box. QUIC members also work their way into the superpowers' intelligence agencies to make sure Diamond Dogs gets work. We have those countries by the balls. That's our deterrent when we need it.
Networking? In the intelligence community?
Sure. That's how we've grown this far. And when you go out on missions, intel from QUIC will be there to back you up. But despite all that, Cypher has its eyes on us. The only reason I'm not dead is that they needed to know where you were. Figured if you woke up, I'd go straight to you.
That's why you made that ruckus at the Zero Line.
Yeah, to make their own surveillance work against them. I think it took some of the heat off Cypress.
Kaz.
Then I just had to wait for you to save me. And I've gotten used to waiting.
Kaz.
That's not all. It was a good chance to scout the market. And with the West wanting the Soviets out of Afghanistan, their agencies are bursting at the seams with funding. Boss, let's start by building up our Afghan presence.
Why put Mother Base in the Seychelles?
We're at the center of the world here.
We're all the way out in the Indian Ocean.
Come on. Lebanon, Sri Lanka, East Timor, and Africa. From here, our reach extends to conflict zones the world over, including Afghanistan, of course.
So it's prime real estate for a mercenary.
Exactly. Latin America isn't as close as I'd like, but we have Amanda and her people to help in that department. And besides, the Seychelles government owes us a favor.
Owes us?
The Seychelles has strong ties to the East, which the West wanted to shake up. It came to a head 3 years ago in an attempted coup. It was a force of South African mercenaries with U.S. backing behind the scenes. They were only platoon size, but South Africa is home to some heavy PFs. Too much for the Seychelles to handle. In the end, they accepted help from the Tanzanian army and quelled the coup. We set up the deal and handled on-site tactical instruction. That led to some training work for the Seychelles military. And when we put down a mutiny within their forces, well, we made a lot of people happy. They don't pay us. They just let us have a piece of their offshore territory on the promise we'll come running if something else happens.
So we're bodyguards, too.
It's a good setup. We can only take Mother Base so far here. We'll have to find somewhere else when this place starts getting big.
Aren't you being a little hasty?
Nothing hasty about it. You're back with us now.
So, Kaz, the ship that took us from Cyprus, it used to be a whaler.
Yeah, a Japanese vessel. How was the voyage?
It was... stimulating.
Well, she was part of a whaling fleet up until a few years ago. Her displacement isn't anything to write home about, but she can really move. She still had plenty of life left in her, but then the work dried up. Global opposition to whaling has been mounting for years.
Is that right?
The push to ban it has been gaining traction for a little over a decade. Individual species came under protection as the years went on. And then 2 years ago, the IWC adopted a moratorium on commercial whaling. Several countries, including Japan, fought it to the bitter end. But eventually, most whaling companies had no choice but to throw in the towel. You ever tried whale snake?
Can't say that I have.
When I was a kid in Japan, practically everybody ate it.
That good, huh?
The country was poor in those days. And whale was cheap. International opinions changed since then. In any case, that's why we were able to get a bargain price on the ship. Of course, we did end up spending 5 times the purchase price in modifications. We had to really work to fit in all the ESM and communications gear while keeping the whaler look intact. Right now, she's going around conducting SIGINT missions. In the future, we plan to use her as a communications relay base between you and Mother Base. And also as a chopper resupply vessel. Diamond Dogs. The word diamond originally comes from the Greek adamas. It means indomitable, unyielding. Other words for the stones often mean eternal bond, fortitude, or purity. The same is true of the Star of Bethlehem flowers you laid on the boss's grave. They represent innocence, as well as chastity. Yielding to no man while maintaining one's virtue. In other words, staying loyal to something.
Boss! Let us know if you need supplies, boss.
What's up, boss?
Ocelot said the number of private forces is increasing, and they've modeled themselves after us.
They're a far cry from the likes of us.
But why? 9 years ago, we made enemies of the world as a nuclear-equipped force, independent of ideology or state.
Yes. Sooner or later, the real UN would have stepped in.
So why are they giving these PFs free rein?
That's our fault, too.
What do you mean?
What happened 9 years ago was a real problem for a lot of people. An organization as big as ours, with our facilities, was wiped off the map. Not an easy thing to hide. But if our existence came to light, so would the names of our clients. We had contracts all over, east and west, from superpowers to banana republics, the lot. Our clients denied all association with the likes of us. They had to make sure things didn't blow up on them. But at the same time, they missed us. They really missed us. The demand for armies for hire was as strong as ever. The international community turned a blind eye to what happened to us, despite still needing people who could do our jobs. History couldn't afford to lose us. As soon as we were gone, they needed a replacement. So private forces spread everywhere. And they're all just a phone call away.
But still.
I know. PFs are totally different from what we envisioned. Nation states, revolutionaries, terrorists. They have a lot of clients. Cypher is one of them. Cypher stays anonymous, but I know their work when I see it. In the eyes of those clients, the world's PFs are all just expendable pawns. The clients don't have to worry about losing their own men. Nobody knows they're involved, and PFs are cheap. In short, the world is chewing up soldiers and spitting them out. Even some of the old Mother Base's survivors are still working for PFs. Some guys created their own smaller forces. Others were taken on by emerging PFs. Everybody's gone their separate ways. But none of them are living their dream, because they're not fighting with you. Of course, I tried to headhunt as many of them as I could for Diamond Dogs. It was all a waste of time. They said they weren't interested without you to lead them. But now you're back. And everything's gonna change. We'll unite all private forces under you, transcending nations and economies. What is a nation? Just a patch of dirt. The bonds among us will surpass nations, and that's what'll put the world under our control. We'll establish a new kind of country, redefine the very concept of it. Even Cypher will be below us, an extraterritorial federation of military nations, the United States of Force. Once word of Big Boss's return starts traveling, that'll be our true deterrent against Cypher. In other words, no one will dare to come gunning for you.
How do you figure?
Cypher lacks a large-scale fighting force. PFs are the perfect tool for them. But those PFs revere you, the legendary Big Boss. If Cypher killed you now, they wouldn't take it lying down. Maybe they'd even go looking for revenge, but they definitely wouldn't keep doing Cypher's dirty work, even if it put their lives at stake. That's why it's no longer a benefit to Cypher to get rid of you. The very fact that you're alive is our greatest defense against Cypher.
Nice to know. It'll buy us some time while we get back to full strength.
Just keep in mind that what I'm saying is generalizing a lot. In practice, the PFs around the world don't know your face. Just declaring that you're Big Boss won't be enough to convince them. And if they see you as an enemy, they'll come at you with everything they've got.
Some hero.
That's why you need to bring them back to Mother Base. Show them on your terms that you really are the one and only Big Boss. Once you've proven that, they won't hesitate to join us. Snake, do you remember Amanda?
Yeah, I do.
Their revolution was a success. Somoza resigned. Nicaragua has a new government. Amanda's really working hard for her country to be reborn.
Good for them.
She says she wishes Chico could be there.
That revolution was the dream. For Amanda. For Chico. And their father.
That chopper was no place for Chico to die. I'd like to at least think history will remember his part in the revolution.
When you pick up a gun, there's always a chance you'll die for nothing. He knew that as well as the rest. Now that he's gone, it's up to the rest of us to decide what it was all worth. If we don't, there's nothing to prove that Chico ever lived at all. We're his mark on the world.
Amanda told us that Strangelove contacted her after the revolutionaries came to power in Nicaragua. Strangelove, the AI researcher from Mother Base?
I remember her.
We'd lost touch with her, till Amanda heard from her out of the blue. She told Amanda she wanted to salvage Peace Walker's drive parts or something from the bottom of Lake Nicaragua. Amanda passed the request on to her friends in the new administration. She's a national hero now, after all. So Strangelove got a Soviet military aircraft to transport something to somewhere. But apparently the cargo wasn't big enough to have been Peace Walker itself.
So what was it?
Who knows? We recovered Peace Walker's nuclear warhead ourselves 9 years ago. What could Strangelove have been after? Amanda said she didn't mention what her reason was or where she was headed. Nicaragua is a socialist state now. With Amanda vouching for her, the government didn't feel the need to concern itself with the details. All Strangelove told Amanda was that she was going to continue her research, and that the rest was a secret. Right before the attack, Huey was in the control tower to prepare for the inspectors. He was with them when it
Roger.
The control tower collapsed with the rest of its strut. His body was never recovered. But he was the one who met the inspection party when they arrived. And he was the one who showed the nuclear inspectors to the tower. You remember the way it went. First he recommends we agree to the inspection. Then he gives them the okay without our permission. All the time acting as if he was doing us a favor. On top of that, he even had the guards disarmed that day. It would send the wrong message, he said. Whatever the angle, it all leads back to Huey. I curse my own stupidity for not realizing sooner. Huey escaped with that unit by chopper. I've been hunting him for 9 long years. The other reason I was operating around Afghanistan was to dig up his location.
Huey's in Afghanistan?
Yes. And I have a good idea where. Now we just wait for the right moment. This time, we'll be the ones using him. He's going to tell us who our guests really were that used a fake nuclear inspection to blast our home into the ocean.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. complete. Plant expansion complete. Unit dispatched. Unit dispatched. Staff assigned. Please select a landing zone. Heading to Afghanistan. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Marker placed. Analysis complete.
That's the target.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete. have arrived at your destination.
Talk. Where are
your
friends?
The map has been updated.
You got to extract him.
Analysis complete. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
Yeah.
presence detected. The map has been updated. Please select a mission. Unit dispatched. Unit dispatched. Staff assigned. Staff assigned. Analysis complete. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Прислали американские империалисты в поддержку дешмана. Кто-то из выживших рассказывал, что у него на голове рог, что он сражается, как одержимый демон.
Богатый мужик? Да он, небось, за них паниковал, съел с катушек.
Может быть.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Jesus.
Will clear shortly.
Spit it out.
The map has been updated.
He's coming too. Roger that. Extract him.
Analysis complete.
On board. Leave the rest to us. He's coming too. Roger that.
Side ops list updated.
Okay, subject is in.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Analysis complete.
Too. Roger that.
Please select a drop. Supplies requested. Supply drop complete.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Please select a drop point. Supplies requested. Supply drop complete. Thank you. storm approaching.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Analysis complete. The weather will clear shortly.
He's coming too. Roger that.
The map has been updated. Outpost captured.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us. pinpoint their anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, but that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now. You can designate a landing zone near the outpost.
Marker removed. Marker removed. Marker placed. Please select a mission. Staff assigned. Please select a mission. Please specify a project. Please select supplies requested. Commencing platform construction. Commencing platform construction. Commencing platform construction. Supply drop complete. Sun will rise momentarily. alarm will set shortly. Sun will rise momentarily. Please select a mission. Mission accepted. The map has been updated. Marker removed. Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Yeah. 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 Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Yeah.
Christmas Eve, 1979. The Soviet Union rolled into Afghanistan. Muslims had revolted against the Soviet-friendly regime established the year before. The DRA forces could no longer contain it themselves, so the Soviets went in to intervene. The Afghan government was powerless and fraught with infighting. They lost the hearts and minds of the people, and that alarmed the Soviet leadership. With the Islamic Revolution happening in Iran, the Soviets felt they had to act fast or risk the spread of Islamic revivalism. A superpower sending a motorized rifle division against men on horseback with antique rifles. Everyone thought it'd be over in an instant, only it wasn't. Some Muslims made their fight a jihad, a holy war, and began a guerrilla campaign on all fronts, a war of attrition. These fighters call themselves Mujahideen. They're being supported by the West through Pakistan. That's why Miller was involved. He was training them near the zero line, sponsored by the CIA. The war has become a nightmare for the Soviet troops stationed here. They thought they'd be headed home in 6 months at the most. Then a year passed. 2 years. Now here we are, 4 years on, with no exit in sight. Afghanistan has become the Soviet Union's Vietnam. The Soviet troops on the ground want to go home, but at least they have homes to go back to. The Afghans have lost theirs. The Soviets destroy the Kishlaks, villages, wherever they can. They burn down homes and fields, fill in wells, turn pastures into minefields. It's created a mass of refugees who fled to Pakistan. If the Mujahideen are fish swimming around the villages, the Soviets will go so far as to dry out their ocean. But this has had a big price. There's bitter resentment among the Afghans, and they're taking out their anger on the soldiers on the front lines. Among the Mujahideen are the Pashtun people. They're fiercely devoted to their code of badal, or revenge. Soviets they've captured have had their hands, feet, and noses cut off before being left to die at the side of the road, just to show their comrades what they're capable
extraction
of. Friendlies who come across them can do nothing but put them out of their misery. Then they burn down another village in retaliation, and the cycle of vengeance goes on.
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Analysis complete. Marker placed. The map has been updated. Analysis. Enemy presence detected. Analysis. The map has been updated. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Has been updated.
Too. Roger that. You gotta extract him.
Марка
выявлена. Держите ухо востро. Конец связи.
Presence detected. The map has been updated. Marker placed. Marker removed. Marker removed. Marker placed. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. You have arrived at your destination.
Talk.
Where are the others?
The map has been updated.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Extraction arrived at mother base.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Extraction arrived at mother base. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Please select a mission. Unit dispatched. Unit dispatched. Staff assigned. Please specify a project. Please select and supplies requested. Please specify a project. Supply drop complete. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Please specify a project. Please specify a project. Please specify a project.
Yeah.
The map has been updated. Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
This mission has two objectives. Eliminate the colonel scheduled to take up a post at Smassi Fort and stop the deployment of his tank unit. Your first move should be to head to Sacré Village and search for the colonel and his deployment plans.
The map has been updated. You have arrived at your destination. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Where are your friends?
The map has been updated.
Extract him.
Yeah.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Analysis complete.
Coming too. Roger that. Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
The map has been updated.
The Soviet tank.
Sam will set shortly.
If you could steal that, nothing could stop you. But make a wrong move, and it'll chew you up. He's coming too. Roger that.
Marker placed. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. You have arrived at your destination.
The
map has been updated.
Roger that.
Intel file extraction arrived at Mother Base. Mission info has been updated. The map has been updated.
Boss, that document you just got is the deployment plans for the Smassi Ford reinforcements. According to the plans, the colonel is supposed to join up with a tank unit of Waxin Barracks and then proceed to Smassi Ford. Those tanks being on the move doesn't make things easy. Hurry, boss. I've sent the tank unit's route to your iDroid.
Updated. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Storm approaching. Shortly. have arrived at your destination. Please select a landing zone. Land support helicopter requested.
You destroyed their anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, but that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now. You can designate a landing zone near the outpost.
Please select a landing zone confirmed.
Roger.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Mission complete. Great work. The NGO that asked us to rescue wild animals isn't ready to take them in yet. So we had no choice but to build an animal conservation platform. The NGO said they'll cover all expenses, including the day-to-day housing and feeding costs. If you're interested, take a chopper over and have a look. Boss, if you got time on your hands, come spend it back at the base. The men will miss you if you're gone too long. Boss, a certain scientist has contacted us, wanting to defect from the East. His name? He's Emmerich. That's right. The man we knew as Huey. We suspect he was complicit in the attack on Mother Base 9 years ago. He was working with Cypher,